In this lesson, it's one of my favorite ones. We're going to be learning a new way to do loops. So if I have a list of incidents, this array of incidents, one of the ways I could iterate through it is, you should all know this one, for let ID in incident IDs, and then you access it by saying incident IDs and then the actual index that you're iterating through. If I press run script, there it is. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. But this gets a little bit complicating if you, for instance, have a nested loop. So what if it looked like this? And then instead, each of these were itself a array of its own. So now if I want to iterate through each of those, I can say let ID 2 in incidents IDs ID, and then it gets further complicating in there when I actually want to log things, because now I have to say incidents incident IDs ID ID 2. So if I run this, yeah, it works, but if I keep getting further and further down, this syntax becomes almost untenable. So to simplify things, what we can use instead of this for in loop, we can actually use for of loop. So in this, we say for of instead, and we can get rid of this whole thing and just use ID. And so instead of ID being an index to help you identify what index you're on in the array, ID takes on the form of that element itself. And so if I press run script, 1, 2, 3. So ID itself is each element inside of the array. This can be pretty useful if you know you don't need the index at all. So if you don't need the index in your script at all, why use it? That's what for of loops are useful for. The other thing that they're useful for is iterating through strings. So if I have a string called status and it is set to the word resolved, if I use the for of loop on this, so for let letter of status, you can actually iterate through the entire string one letter at a time. There you go. R-E-S-O-L-V-E-D. Find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T.